Manx Radio Saturday Live Lounge, supported by Villa Gaiety. For the latest Watson information, visit villagaiety.com.
Oh, I love that. That was a former third song. I think it was only a couple of weeks ago, actually. That is Girl Ray, and that is called Everybody Saying That. Ah, I do like it when I have guests in the studio, and it's always fun when it's Francesca May. Hello, Francesca. How are you?
I'm very well.
I never know whether, because it's kind of stage name, I have to say Francesca rather than Frankie, because you kind of are Francesca as a stage name, aren't you?
Francesca May is my stage name, yeah. But everyone knows me as Frankie.
Well, either way, it's lovely to have you back. And you have been very busy because we're going to play a single which kind of was your new single until... And it, 2 weeks ago and now a week ago you've released another one, so you are being very prolific at the moment, aren't you?
I am, yes, churning them out.
How's it going with it all then? Is it just because you're finding like a massive creative streak and you're just constantly writing?
To be honest, like I've had them lined up for a while. Like we've only recently recorded them, but I did write them like a good few months ago, so I've been waiting and waiting and waiting to get them out. So yeah, just trying to get them all out.
And you've got the perfect companion here, because you've got Andrew, who of course is your kind of studio producer, kind of engineered, writes with you as well. You do all sorts, Andrew, yeah. Don't you?
Yeah, well, that's what makes it a bit easier for you, because we can just write and record in the same day, basically. So I suppose that's probably helped. Yeah. Towards the output.
And you do all this kind of in your own sort of home studio setting,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah, we've got a little space up in Blaff, so... fairly recent, but it's going well, and we've got everything we need there in terms of instruments, so we can do it all ourselves, which is what happened for the latest song.
But, yeah. Well, we've got Missing You is on the Manx Radio playlist. It's on the B list on Manx Radio now, so people will be hearing that a lot. And now I'm going to have to tell them there's another one. So we'll talk about that in a few moments. But why do we hear Missing You? So tell us a little bit about Missing You first, Frankie.
So Missing You, I wrote... it was kind of in lockdown, actually. We were living in London at the time, and Andrew was off at work all the time because, you know, his job was considered essential. So he was off, you know, working, and I was just stuck at home in the flat. So it was a very creative time. I was writing every day, but I wrote this song then. And it's just kind of about... yeah, missing someone. That's the easiest way to say it. Yeah.
So you're saying you're missing Andrew, is that?
What's
it like when you hear it then, Andrew?
It was slower. It started off very much more acoustic-y, didn't it?
It did, yeah.
I suppose, but we sped it up a bit.
Was that through your influence? Did you suggest that?
Yeah, we did it live for a BBC introducing thing, and when we listened back to it, we thought, it's a bit slow. Yeah. So we sped it up, didn't we? And which is usually... changes the song, doesn't it? So, and added a bit of more kind of recent production on it. So
it's kind of morphed into something different.
Yeah. It's very much a driving with the windows down song.
Yeah, really summery vibe to it. Yeah. Really feel good. Well, let's hope that someone is listening in their car now. And if you are listening in your car, get your windows rolled down, cruise up and down the prom, and put this on full volume. This is Francesca May and Missing You.
There's no other way.
is new-ish from Francesca May. It's called Missing You, because she just keeps churning out singles. It's very confusing, but brilliant. I love the fact she's putting out so much new music. And your music's doing very well off Ireland as well, isn't it? As Andrew mentioned, it's being picked up by BBC Introducing. You seem to be across a whole number of different stations now.
Yeah, it's great. So Dave Monk's at BBC Merseyside, he's actually played the new one twice, which doesn't happen very often. And Emma Linton and BBC Cumbria is playing Missing You tonight. And she's given me some support in the past as well, which is great.
Do you get feedback then from people off Ireland when they've heard it?
I do sometimes get a couple of messages, a couple of new followers here and there from people that have heard it. Yeah, it's nice.
Oh, I'm so glad. It's exactly what we need. And there seems to be a lot of that going on with the fantastic music from the island, isn't there, at the moment? There's a lot of artists who are kind of breaking through and getting a lot of international recognition now, which is great. It must feel lovely to be a kind of part of that now.
It is. I love it.
Oh, I'm so pleased. Well, listen, you're going to play for us live shortly. However, while we get everything set up, I thought we'd hear something that you're loving at the moment. So tell us a little bit about what we're going to hear now, this artist Dylan.
So, yes. So this is Dylan. She's a massive influence of ours at the minute. Very like pop rock. She's not afraid to kind of show herself through her music, and we really love it. It was a big influence for the new one and our past releases as well.
Excellent. Well, this is Every Heart But Mine.
Baby walks around like he owns the place. He's got a black suit on, killer smile on his face, and all the girls scream when they hear his name, but not me.
Was a suggested song by my studio guest Francesca May. That is Dylan and Every Heart But Mine, or a suggested artist rather. Francesca really likes Dylan and said good influence on the music that she's been creating with Andrew, who's also here in the studio. and they're going to play something live for us. So, first of all, Frankie, just come right up to the mic and just tell us what we're going to hear and give us a little bit of info about it before you actually sing it for us.
So, this is called Venus. It's a proper soppy love song and it's going to be on the upcoming EP.
So excited. Is this the first time we're going to hear this? That's very cool.
It is, yes.
With Andrew on guitar and Francesca May singing live. Take it away, guys.
Misty eyes in the morning, colored in blue. Maybe I should have told you what I always knew. Show me the way to your heart, 'cause God, I don't know where to start. Secrets drown out the world. Let me be your Venus, love in one word. Show me the way to your heart, 'cause I wanna know where to start. Changed, but I still feel the way that I did. Nothing's the same, but I still look at you like a kid. I travel so far just to get where you are, and without you there's nowhere. Ask me a question, open your eyes. Tell me you love me, I'll paint you the sky. Lend me a piece of your heart, let's take it back to the start. Everything's changed, but I still feel the way that I did. Nothing's the same, but I still look at you like a kid. I travel so far just to get where you are, and without you there's nowhere.
Well, that was gorgeous. I'm going to do the one person clapping thing. Absolutely beautiful. So that's going to be on a forthcoming EP, is it?
It is. It's track number 2.
Oh, so you already know the track list.
Oh, yeah.
This is great. How many tracks are going to be on it?
6 in total, but there is a story there as well.
Well, tell you what, hold that thought. We'll come back to it in a moment. That was Francesca and Andrew playing live in the studio. We'll chat more to them after this.
Lex Radio's winning weekend. Play to win at manxradio.com. Whether you like your martini shaken or stirred, you'll find everything is just perfect at Bond's Restaurant in Onchan, where your host and new owner, Saeed, formerly of the Italian Job, will ensure that you enjoy a fabulous experience from the moment you arrive. Whether dining for two or holding a celebration, Bond's will exceed your expectations with superb food without the fine dining price tag. For menus, upcoming theme nights and online bookings, visit bonds.im. Bond's.
Through and through. Great. Claus, settle down! This September, you won't have any excuses for not having the correct school equipment. In fact, your homework is to get down to Office World and see their huge back-to-school range. Stock up on pens, pencils, files, folders, and novelty post-it notes, and don't miss the amazing 3-for-2 offer on all Pilot pens. Office World are top of the class with their back-to-school range. Class dismissed. Office World, near the Isle of Man sorting office. Open Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. with free parking.
Oh, problems with your spine and posture can have a serious effect on your quality of life. But Align for Life Spine Clinic could help. If you're suffering from back pain, neck pain, headaches, their holistic scientific approach could find and treat the root cause of the problem for long-lasting relief. Whew. Touch Align for Life now or call 629-444. Align for Life, the island's spine and posture clinic, here to make life better.
Manx Radio. Manx Radio Saturday Live Lounge, supported by Villa Gaiety. For the latest Watson information, visit villagaiety.com.
Yeah!
that is Led Zeppelin. Of course it's Led Zeppelin. And Ramble On. It is Christy with you through till 7pm. And then, of course, it'll be Marky B with a party for you. And I have studio guests. And it's lovely because we're having a really nice, chill session this evening. I've basically just got Francesca and Andrew to just stay. I mean, I don't know how long you're able to stay. But we're just having a lovely time, aren't we, really? So if you just tuned in, you missed a little live set a few minutes ago. A song from a new EP. Which do we know when it's going to be out, this EP?
First of September.
Yeah. Okay, so we're very much looking forward to that. And we've heard a couple of the songs that we know are going to be on it. We just had a preview of another song. What else is going on this EP then? What's the kind of plan for it?
So the whole kind of track list, it was originally going to be called the How It Ends EP. It was 5 songs. It was going to be Yellow Line, Red Light, which you've heard, Missing You, which you've heard, and then Venus, which was the live song we just did, and How It Ends. And then we wrote Leave Me On Fire, and it was like, oh, do I hang on to it or do I add it? And we decided in the end to add it. So now it's called the Hopelessly Lovestruck EP.
Oh.
And it kind of tells the tale of a relationship from start to end. So the track list tells a story.
Oh, I love that. That's like a proper classic old album, the way albums used to be. Oh, that's fab. Do you listen to albums? Or are you more of a kind of just...
Yeah, so Andrew actually got me a record player for Christmas. So
love it. Well done, Andrew.
Yeah, I never used to sit and listen to albums, but now that, you know, I can buy the records and sit and actually put them on.
I love it. Honestly, yeah. It wasn't for me.
Are you a vinyl fan then?
I do, yeah. I love vinyl. Yeah. So
what vinyl do you...
It was a bit of a both present for both.
Yeah. What goes on more often than not?
I like a lot of the classic. I mean, I love Wings. Wings are amazing for me. So any Beatles, Fleetwood Mac, the classic stuff from the 70s. But we have been buying. You've bought some of the modern stuff, haven't you? The Harry Styles one's good. The new Harry Styles.
Oh, he's excellent.
That
isn't
new
he?
Album was.
What else did I get? I've got Dua Lipa, the new Dylan album as well. And Olivia Rodrigo as well.
I love that there are, because in the kind of streaming society we've got, it feels like, oh, people just want one song and then they move on. But actually, because of vinyl coming back, it's kind of brought back the album a little bit, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has.
Yeah.
It's great.
I think that's kind of the idea, is to maybe try and improve your own songwriting as well through listening to what used to be known as kind of album tracks or filler tracks. Yeah. Where if you listen to all that stuff, you get... It can only help, can't it? So,
So is your plan to eventually come out with a vinyl then?
It would be great. Yeah, I'd love to bring out my own vinyl. Maybe in the future. We'll see.
We'll see how we go. Well, listen, what we'll do, I think we'll have a little tune by Corinne Bailey-Ray, the latest one from her, which is really punchy and really quick because it's like power punk. It's amazing. It's not like you expect from Corinne Bailey-Ray at all. We'll have that. Then we're going to ask you what your firsts are, which is our new little feature here on the Live Lounge. And then we're going to leave with Leave Me On Fire, which you just alluded to there. So we'll come back to that one. OK, so after we hear Corinne Bailey-Ray, we are going to have Francesca and Andrew's firsts here on the show. Just had a message in from Pauline H saying great music. And that was even before the mighty Led Zeppelin. So enjoying everything from you guys here, which is lovely to hear. And somebody else has just messaged to say, there's refreshment for the Live Lounge waiting at the Manx Radio door. I might send one of you guys down to see what it is. If it's booze, we're not allowed, but we wouldn't tell anyone anyway. New York Transit Queen, New York Transit Queen, New York Transit Queen, little over 17. She rides. That's 1 minute 41 of Corinne Bailey Ray, a New York transit queen. It's pretty cool, isn't it?
It is.
Not what you expect from Corinne Bailey Ray at all. Power punk there on the go. Well, listen, we're going to chat to you now before we hear your new single, which is Leave Me On Fire. More of that in just a moment. But before that, I just want to do this new feature with you. Okay, so over the past few weeks, we have been chatting to each of our guests, finding out a bit about them and their background in music by hearing what their firsts are, which you've been really worried about this, Frankie, haven't you?
She doesn't like getting put on the spot.
Do you feel like you're on the spot, right?
A little bit, yeah, because I don't know, I can never think of what, you know,
because you've got to fess up, basically.
Exactly, yeah.
I love it when we have, because we've had some, you know, kind of quite heavy acting who've admitted to things like their first album was the Spice Girls and stuff like that, which is just brilliant. Well, I'm going to get my little notes here. Okay, so come to you first then, Frankie, not to put the pressure on you or anything. What was the, now this is going to be interesting for you, the first album or maybe piece of music that you bought, and in what format was it?
Okay, so when, I can't remember how old I was, but my parents bought me an iPod Nano, and we had, I don't know, was it iTunes back in that day? I don't remember, but my dad downloaded me, and I'm sure it was Doo-Wops and Hooligans by Bruno Mars. It might have been Katy Perry. Those are kind of mixed up.
Yeah.
Those are definitely some of the first ones.
I love it because it also sort of ages the person. You're so young, it's wonderful. What about you, Andrew? Do you remember what yours was?
I do, actually. Yeah, mine was a CD. It wasn't out when I was that age, but I think it was the Spaghetti Incident. Is that what it was called? The Spaghetti Incident by Guns N' Roses. It was just an album that had spaghetti on it. Is
oh,
that what
I
it was
love
called?
That. Do you know what? I can't remember
it
what the album itself was called.
It was the one after Appetite for Destruction,
Which songs were on it?
Do you know what? I can't
remember.
There'll
be someone listening who knows.
Probably, yeah. I think that's what it was called. I could be completely wrong there.
Did you have it on, like, repeat? Was it just kind of...
I did. I kind of went through that stage where I was just into like Iron Maiden and Guns N' Roses, and but yeah, that was kind of what I was into at that age. I was probably about 13 or 14, I think. So
heavy stuff.
Yeah, not so completely changed throughout the years. I don't tend to listen to that stuff much anymore, but
that's what I find interesting, though, is what's influenced you over the years and how people's music tastes changed throughout that time. Okay, so back to you then, Francesca. What is your first memory of seeing live music, of like what would be the sort of first gig you went to? Do you remember what that is?
I was about 12 and we went to see Rihanna.
No way.
I loved it. Yeah.
An experience.
Yeah, my parents and me and my sister.
Was it like a big stadium gig then?
Yeah, it was it was a proper good first gig to go to.
Yeah.
She played like Umbrella and, you know, all the hits. It was, loved it.
Oh, that is so cool. All right, come on then, Andrew, what was yours?
Yeah, mine was in 2007. I went to see the Foo Fighters.
Again, so awesome.
I was a bit of a guitar music and like a bit of a rock stuff when I was a bit younger. I was 17. I went with my dad. So the great thing about that gig was when we got there, we didn't realise, because it didn't say on the ticket, it just said with support, but they had the Future Heads opened.
No way.
And then Manic Street Preachers were on for like about an hour and a half.
So what a lineup.
I know. So
that's incredible. So that's three awesome acts.
Big awesome acts, on the same day. So it was, that was great. Yeah, that was my first ever time at a gig.
That's reminding me, one of the biggest gigs I saw first was U2 at Wembley, and opening for them was Björk and the Stereo MCs. Yeah. And it was just, again, you get that sort of
complete
whole thing
surprise,
of three awesome acts all in one. Okay, right. So what was it? What's your first gig performing yourself? Do you remember where and when that was?
It was Rock School when I was I was like 11. So I went to this like summer camp, and we spent a whole week practicing and, you know, playing together, and then we put on a little show at the end.
Love it. Do you remember what you played? Because it'd be covers, I presume.
Well, yeah, so I actually played that was when I wrote my first ever song, and we played that one. It was called Shine Through, and it was really quite dark for an 11-year-old, but and then we played, was it Forget You by CeeLo Green? And
I've seen the video.
What? Sorry, I'm sorry. Come back to that. There's video.
There's evidence of this out there.
There is video. Yeah. Okay, where is this video, Andrew?
It's on my mum's computer. It is not in the public domain, fortunately.
Somebody needs to release this video. I mean, you are clearly going to be a huge superstar. So, I mean, if you can get hold of this, if anyone can get hold of this, your mum's going to do it, isn't it?
She will.
She's going to release it.
Eventually, she will. Yeah.
She will.
It'll
yeah,
be
she'll
on
make,
YouTube later.
She'll make millions from it. Oh, I can't wait to see that one. All right, then. And I'm just going to ask you both one last question then. What is the first artist that comes to mind if I say recommend somebody to me? Who would you always want to recommend to me?
Oh, you go first. I'm going to have to think about this.
Okay.
Just from what I've been listening to lately, Wolfpack.
Oh, Wolfpack are fantastic. They're completely batty.
I know they're
batty.
Quite big anyway, so...
well, not really. There's a lot of people that don't know them, to be honest. So,
but that's kind of what I've been
really
listening to
lately.
Really funky,
incredibly stuff, yeah. clever musicians, yeah. aren't they? Yeah. And they are so brilliantly odd.
Yeah.
They're
yeah.
really quirky. Like, they did an album in a sauna or something, didn't they?
Yeah.
With little red fezzes on. Completely batty, but
they
honestly
make it
really
sound
good.
Fantastic, though.
They do.
To listen to, so yeah. They have a weird way of doing it, but it works.
Wolfpack is a great shout. Yeah. I'm loving that, and I would definitely agree with that one. Right, go on then. No pressure, Francesca.
I've been really liking Maisie Peters at the minute.
Again, excellent shout. Really good stuff, and it makes sense with your kind of style and your music and everything as well. So that's good. Well, listen, I love hearing these things. I love hearing your first, because now we know more about you. But what we are going to do now is we're going to play you out with your new single. This was released yesterday. Tell me a little bit about Leave Me On Fire before we hear it.
So Andrew actually started writing this one on the piano, and it was completely different. And I came in and went, no, change that. So we rewrote the lyrics and then, added guitars and made it a little bit more rocky. And then we basically got straight into the studio the next day after writing it. I was really excited about it. Yeah. So we wanted to get it down. And here we are. Yeah.
Well, listen, we're going to hear it. But before we do, tell us a little bit, because you're going to be going on tour, aren't you? Tell us where you're going on tour and when.
So we're hoping to go in October. We're not sure exact dates yet, but we're hoping just kind of around the Midlands. So northwest, northeast. Leeds, Manchester, Liverpool, Newcastle, that kind of area.
Excellent. So you're UK fans. And what's the setup going to be, Andrew? How is it going to
look? Yeah, it's probably going to be me and you with track. So we've been doing a lot of stuff with track from the songs that are going to be on the EP, just elements of the song. So that seems to work quite well. We've been doing it lately. So.
Yeah. It sounds like you've really settled into the local scene now, haven't you?
Yeah. We've settled in nicely and got a little space to record as well, so... Yeah.
Excellent. Well, listen, where can we find out about, first of all, obviously you, Frankie, tell us about your various social media pages.
So I am at Francesca May G pretty much everywhere. On Facebook, I'm Francesca May. Just type in Francesca May. You'll probably find me.
I think you probably will. And what about the studio, Andrew?
Yeah, it's AJ Production on Facebook. So
excellent. Well, as ever, it's lovely to see you both. And we're going to leave you with Leave Me On Fire, the brand new single. This got out yesterday, so you can download this and listen to it over and over again to your heart's content. Let us know when you've got the vinyl out, won't you?
I will.
Cheers, guys.
Manx Radio Saturday Live Lounge, supported by Villa Gaiety. For the latest Watson information, visit villagaiety.com.